about to head out and go on a little staycation with my family in Manhattan. Also, I just ate lunch and I feel so tired. I will not be surprised if I fall asleep on the way into the city. Okay, let's go.
We're at the Met. We have been looking for this musical instruments exhibit for the past like 20 minutes.
But now we finally found it. And neither Stephanie or myself play any instruments. We're online waiting to see the Walt Disney exhibit, and the line goes through like 5 exhibits. It is so long, but it's kind of why we came, so. The wait for the Disney exhibit was 30 minutes long, and we waited for it. But I think it was worth it. It was pretty cool, like very different, and they showed the original sketches and inspiration for a lot of the films and the Disney princess movies. Now we're gonna go and meet up with our parents to get dinner at this place called Tomi Jazz in Midtown. It's supposed to be like, has a really cool happy hour, which is why Steph wanted to go. And they also have live jazz music starting at 6. I hope we get to see it. I think it's gonna be very, very loud. Okay, we're sharing this room. And mom and dad are in this room. Cute. I feel like it's bigger than the photos. Okay. This is very nice. Oh, there's another bathroom. Okay.
I want my cannoli.
Like 8:30. We just got to the Airbnb, so my parents just dropped off our stuff earlier while Steph and I were at the Met, which was very nice of them. Also, dinner was so good, like so good. That place was called Tomi Jazz. The happy hour prices were insane. We got 4 entrees, 4 drinks, and a ton of apps. And since it was happy hour, it was already discounted. And then the guy, when he gave us the bill, said if we paid cash, it'd be 10% off. So in total, it was $135, which was such a good price for the amount of food we got. After that, I still got a cannoli from Little Italy, and it was amazing at Ferrara's. The food was just so good tonight. I really recommend it. I've been to a couple of places where they do live music, and sometimes it's way too loud, like so, so, so loud. And this time, it wasn't. I think the instruments were just softer. It was piano, a flute, and maybe something else. I couldn't see, someone was in the corner. It was really nice, and it was such a speakeasy vibe, which I really like, and it's hard to get into speakeasies in the city, but it is a Tuesday, so maybe that's why it was calmer. But when we left, oh my god, the line was so, so long. Thank you. We just finished eating breakfast at this place called Pause Cafe. It was very, very good. It's right across from
Clinton Street Bakery on Houston, but the wait there was an hour long and we weren't gonna wait for that. So we went to this cute little cafe. Lots of Middle Eastern and Mediterranean types of decorations and flavors, which I really appreciated. I would definitely go back there, and I found it last night on Yelp. You could tell it gets crowded though. It's a little bit of a gloomy day in the city, but our plan is just to walk around downtown, like East Village, Soho, NoHo, Nolita, Little Italy. And I really want to go to West Village and Greenwich Village because I don't really get to go over there often. So I kind of just want to look at the houses because I know there's lots of townhouses and cute shops. This is my book review of what books are supposed to be best of the best. This book, good story, but I'm not into biographies or autobiographies personally. This book, really good, life-changing, love the lessons. This book, probably one of my favorite classics. I had to read it for school. I liked it. It's just very detailed and very thick.
This book, couldn't get into it.
Good book.
Very good. Couldn't get into it.
I want to read. I want to read. I definitely want to read. Great book. This is Carrie Bradshaw's apartment from Sex and the City, where they filmed it. Although I think she lives in Upper East Side in the actual series. Okay, and then you can see it. There's a tour here.
We are crystal girls. Rose quartz.
And now we're at the friend's apartment. Right here. Then also, Ryan Reynolds and his wife, I think they used to live right here. Last time we were in this area, there was a ton of paparazzi people standing outside of this courtyard, and they were saying that Ryan Reynolds lives here and they just saw him. So they might have moved because everyone knew where they were living.
No, maybe it is right.
Why would we come here for publicity?
I guess so.
You can just go like a little bit south and then come back.
One time when I came over here with my friend Rachel, we ate at this restaurant. I think it was this one or the other corner. And it was called like 27 Morton or something because it's on Morton Street, and that's just the address. And it was so good. It was like Eastern European food. But now it's out of business because of COVID, so another restaurant took over. I don't come here often, but whenever I'm over here, I'm like, I wish I could eat there again. It was so good. Okay, there's this very long line down the block for this coffee shop called Ame Leon Dor, and I think it's famous because of TikTok, but I heard the coffee is like $9 and then it doesn't taste that great. So I think TikTok has really hyped it up because it's super aesthetic and you get a free glass bottle if you purchase your coffee in it or something, so it's very pretty. But I heard it's not actually great, but I've never been there, so I guess I can't say that. There's clearly a line for a reason.
Ooh. Tofu skin, rice, mushrooms. What kind of sauce is this?
Green aioli.
Okay, green aioli. I really wanted to go to Yubu, but this is basically the same thing.
Very cool, not liquor store. It's like a booze-free liquor store called Spirited Away. And basically they sell all these mixers and wine type drinks that are non-alcoholic. Like they've removed the alcohol or somehow created them without any alcohol in them, which is very cool. But I don't think I've seen an actual shop like that, although I've heard of the concept before. So it's very interesting to see it in person. I wish I could try it though.
As you can tell, we walked around a lot today. We kind of stayed in the downtown Manhattan area, more of the neighborhoods. Also, dinner was so good. We went to this place called Gelso and Grand. I've been there a couple years ago, but I've been meaning to go back, and I love the ambiance. It's like a little dark, candle lit, I guess a little bit more intimate, and it's in Little Italy. We have to leave our rental tomorrow, but I think we're just gonna grab breakfast and go. It's pretty early right now, but we just wanted to come back because we've been walking around all day. My mom said she walked like 21,000 steps. Definitely time to just relax and shower and just get cleaned up for the night.